Diamond Launchers, the least fun you'll ever have playing Call of Duty. But if you want to unlock Dark Matter, then you have no choice but to complete every camo challenge on the Sigma 2 and the RPG. The camo challenges you have to complete with these weapons are absurd. For example, getting double kills with the Sigma 2, a weapon that doesn't shoot straight and only one-shots if you direct impact an enemy, is just ludicrous. Or destroying aerial vehicles that are hundreds of meters away with the RPG, a weapon that doesn't lock on. Yeah, that one's pretty stupid too. But trust me, getting these weapons gold and diamond is 100% worth it just for that final feeling of relief, knowing you never have to touch them again.
Damn it, my heart is racing. I want this. Come on. I hit it. No! No, come on. Two in a row. Yes, we're done. Dark Matter camo. Get that scoreboard out of the way. Come on, give it to me. Dark Matter camo. Come on. Yes, we did it!
And that's why I'm here to help with this video. I will be providing tips that I wish I knew from the beginning of this grind, and these will significantly reduce the amount of time it takes you to get these weapons gold. Everything is included in this guide, from leveling the launchers and the best class setups to detailed and factually correct tips for every single camo challenge. So before we get started on the camo challenges, we need to level the launchers up. This leveling advice is based on exactly what I would do if I had to do the launcher grind again. Feel free to make adjustments and mix it up if you need to, but if you want the most efficient way to level the launchers up, then I recommend sticking to my advice. So the absolute fastest way to level both of the launchers up to 30 is in zombies. And for the whole leveling process, no matter what options you choose, I am assuming you're using double weapon XP tokens, and by assuming I mean you absolutely 100% should be. Leveling the launchers in zombies is, it's kind of fun. I mean, it depends how much you enjoy zombies. I personally don't love it, but it doesn't take too long. With double weapon XP, it took about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours max. And that's with me doing it, someone who has not experienced the zombies. I don't know the best leveling methods, and there's plenty of videos out there for the absolute craziest XP. But honestly, I think an hour and a half to 2 hours to level up the launchers is absolutely fine. The method I ended up using was basically just in Outbreak. All I did was go around the map, completing all the objectives, destroying any large packs of zombies that you found, complete the main objective, and then you can either warp to the next level, or you can just exfil, kill all the zombies on your way there, because there's absolutely tons of them when you're trying to get to that helicopter, and then just rinse and repeat. I did find that just doing it on the first difficulty, exfilling and repeating it was the best way. I did try going up to difficulty 2 and even 3 a couple of times, and it just didn't feel that good. The zombies are way more powerful, they're way tougher to kill. But again, if you are a zombies expert, you probably can handle those difficulty levels quite easily, and it might be a bit more efficient for you. But for me, the best way to do it was just rinse and repeat difficulty 1 on Outbreak. If you want to mix it up, then absolutely feel free to play the other zombies maps. I kind of wish I did just play a few rounds on the other maps, to be honest. So zombies is by far the best way to level up both the launchers. However, with the Sigma 2, there is a second option, and this is to level it up passively whilst you're using another weapon. So this option is best if you're going for other weapons in the Dark Matter grind, other primary weapons. So if you're using an assault rifle, for example, just stick the Sigma 2 on as your secondary. And then basically whenever any enemy spy planes or care packages or any sort of thing that you can destroy gets called in, then you just whip it out and destroy it. And then eventually you'll slowly be leveling up your Sigma 2. If you've got double weapon XP on again, then you're getting kind of double the effect from it, because you're going to be leveling that primary, and whenever there's spy planes, you're going to be getting that double XP on the Sigma 2. But once you hit level 15 on the Sigma, if you are passively leveling it, make sure that you destroy any sentry turrets or RCXDs or just ground vehicles, depending on which game mode you're playing, because every ground streak really helps. Whichever option you take, I highly recommend you level the launcher all the way up to 30. Yes, this is quite a grind, but it is 100% worth it in the long term. And then once you get to level 30, now you'll start thinking about playing multiplayer. So let's talk through the general class setup that I find best to use there. This class setup is the general best class setup you can use when using the launchers, and it does change depending on what challenge you're going for, and I'll give you those details when we talk about each specific challenge. But as a whole, this is kind of the best overall class setup you can be using. The absolute most important part of this setup is Danger Close. This is because it gives you extra ammo in your launcher, which really helps you destroy more vehicles or kill more enemies or just anything. Danger Close, absolutely key here. As for the perks, Engineer is a must. You always want this perk to be on. The only time you can really take it off and maybe put on Flak Jacket is if you're specifically going for double kills. But for any time that you're trying to destroy vehicles, I highly recommend putting Engineer on. In perk 2, Gearhead is absolutely great for getting your field upgrade more often and be able to store more charges of them. And I guess we'll cover the field upgrade now because we're here. And in this slot, you want to be using the assault pack. So obviously, once you've run out of ammo in your launcher, you can just whack it down, get some more ammo, then carry on shooting the score streaks or enemies. You can also put Scavenger on in perk 2. That kind of works quite well, but Gearhead's just a bit more consistent. And in perk 3, Cold-Blooded is the perk that I use here. And this is just because it stops any enemy-controlled score streaks, such as chopper gunners or VTOLs, from being able to see you. And also sentry turrets and attack helicopters helicopters won't shoot you either. So cold-blooded just really helps keep you alive when you're trying to shoot down score streak. In tactical, we run smoke grenades. These are just useful for kind of blocking lines of sight and keeping you alive. Lethal, you can run whatever you want realistically, but molotovs can help just soften enemies a little bit, so then when you're trying to blow them up or punch them, it helps you one-shot them a lot more consistently. And then in the primary, you can use whatever you want. I would recommend putting a barrel attachment on that increases your damage against vehicles. This is just so that if you're shooting counter spy planes or attack helicopters, you're able to just soften them up a little bit with your primary and then one-shot them with your secondary. And that covers the general best class setup for the launchers. Like I said, any changes required for specific challenges, I will let you know when we get there. So let's move on to the camo challenges. Whilst I'm talking, I will be showing some gameplay examples of how to get these challenges done, just to kind of really bring in that context for you. Some of this gameplay I recorded after getting these launchers diamond, and you'll be able to see that I've got the beautiful Dark Matter skin there. But for some of the harder and more frustrating challenges, I have used gameplay from my RNG Camo Mastery series. And that series is a Road to Dark Matter grind, but with the twist of the order in which I get the weapon's gold is decided by a random number generator. And on top of that, the last few episodes also included a completely random class setups as well. So if you haven't seen that series, please do go give it a watch. For each camo challenge, I'll be following more or less the same structure, and this will be the level that it is unlocked, the requirements in order to complete it, the best game modes for completing the challenge, the detailed tips to help you get through the challenge as quick as possible, and a difficulty rating for the challenge for both the Sigma and the RPG. Unlocked at level 1 are the spray challenges. So for these challenges, you have to get 50 eliminations with the Sigma 2 in multiplayer. Now this challenge is so easy, it is something that is just guaranteed to happen whilst you're doing this gun, so I'm not even going to go into any details on this because it's not worth the time. So this moves us on to the Stripes camo. These are unlocked at level 5, and to unlock these camos you've got to destroy 50 equipment score streaks or vehicles with the Sigma 2, or 25 for the RPG. Again, this challenge is something that just will absolutely happen whilst you're doing the other camo challenges, so we don't need to go into this, we'll keep moving, which means we're now onto the classic skins unlocked at level 10. In order to complete these camo challenges, you have got to get 2 kills without dying 20 times. This challenge used to be ridiculously hard because when the game first came out, it used to be get 3 kills without dying, which with these launchers, I can't even imagine attempting to do that. But now that it's just 2 kills, this challenge has become ridiculously easy because you have to get 25 double kills later on anyway, which means it is impossible to not get this challenge done whilst you're doing double kills. So again, and for the last time, we're going to skip over this challenge because it is just so simple. And this is where the grind really starts to pick up in difficulty. With the geometric skins unlocked at level 15, you have got to destroy 50 ground based score streaks or vehicles in multiplayer with the Sigma 2, or with the RPG, this is 25. For this challenge, you will want to make one adjustment to the general class setup I showed earlier, and that is swap cold-blooded to spycraft. This is because the best game mode to do this challenge is in Fireteam Dirty Bomb. The reason why we run spycraft is because in Fireteam Dirty Bomb, it is just constant counter UAVs. People literally find them in boxes in the map. So without the spycraft perk, you will never have your minimap. You'll never be able to see your main map next to the scoreboard as well, which is a really important thing to see when you're going for this challenge. So the general strategy for destroying ground-based score streaks, and this is basically the same for the RPG and the Sigma 2, is when you respawn in Fireteam Dirty Bomb, you spawn in the air, you pull your parachute immediately, you then want to check the big map, so you bring up the scoreboard, press LB, RB, L1, R1, whatever you've got it bound to, or whichever controller you're using, and you just sit and watch this map until you see an enemy get in a vehicle. When they do so, the vehicle will turn red on the map, and you'll be able to see exactly where they are at all times. You then go off the map, cut your parachute, and dive bomb straight towards them. If you're using the Sigma 2, this is quite easy because you're able to lock on from far away and fire at them, but you don't want to shoot from too far away because they'll get an incoming missile warning and will likely just get out of the vehicle, wasting your opportunity. So make sure you get nice and close before you shoot that locked on rocket. With the RPG, obviously it doesn't lock on, so you've got to basically dive bomb right on top of them, fire the rocket at the last second and probably fall to your death, but that's absolutely fine because honestly you just want to respawn, get back in the air and try again. It is worth being aware that when an enemy gets out of a vehicle, you do have about 1 or 2 seconds to actually destroy it, and you'll still get the appropriate medal for whichever vehicle they were in. Obviously it's best to try and avoid this situation because you want it to be consistent, but if the enemy gets out of their vehicle and you're able to destroy it pretty much straight away anyway, do destroy it because it will count if you're quick enough. You'll know when a vehicle you've destroyed counts towards the challenge because you will get one of the many medals associated with destroying a ground-based score streak. To name a few, there's Breakdown, Takedown, and Scrapped, and many others depending on what you actually destroy. So make sure you familiarize yourself with those medals, and whenever you see it, that 100% will count towards the challenge. Another option for destroying ground-based score streaks in Fireteam Dirty Bomb is on maps like Ruka or Sanatorium. You basically get into a nice high vantage point where you can see a lot of the map. You land there, and then again, you just look at your map and wait for an enemy to get in a vehicle. If you're using the Sigma 2, you then lock on, hopefully from where you are. It's just a nice spot and you can shoot your missile at them. Or if you're using the RPG, you then jump down, parachute across and blow them up, like I said earlier. This challenge is then just a case of rinsing and repeating these tips over and over again until you finally get the score streaks destroyed. With the RPG, this didn't take me too long. It took literally about 4 games, I think it was, of Fireteam Dirty Bomb. I did get incredibly lucky with how many vehicles there were in those games though. So I'd say a more realistic number is probably 6 or 7 games to get the 25. And then the 50, well, it's basically going to be double that. If for some reason you can't stand playing Fireteam Dirty Bomb, or if you just want to mix it up a bit, then Combined Arms can work as well. But I did find Fireteam Dirty Bomb was by far the most consistent method for getting this challenge done. And for that reason, I would only recommend doing it in Fireteam Dirty Bomb if you want to get it done anytime soon. Of course, though, if you are doing any other challenges in normal modes, or if you're leveling the launchers passively and you see a sentry turret or an RCXD, then 100% whip out a launcher and just destroy it. Reducing the amount of time you spend on this part of the grind is absolutely a win. As to be honest, this camo challenge isn't actually that challenging, it's just tedious. The difficulty rating for this challenge with the RPG is kind of annoying. And with the Sigma 2, it's settle in for a long and boring grind. The next challenge unlocked at level 20 are the Flora skins. For these, you must destroy 50 aerial score streaks with the Sigma 2 or 25 with the RPG. For this camo challenge, you want to be using the general class setup I mentioned earlier on, and the best game mode for this is 12v12 Mosh Pit or Nuketown 24/7. I'm going to get the Sigma 2 out of the way first, and that's because this challenge is just so, so simple with this weapon. The ability to lock onto these aerial vehicles makes this challenge trivial with the Sigma 2. You'll get it done in no time, it'll be no trouble whatsoever. So we'll move straight onto the RPG, and now this challenge with the RPG is something else. Yes, you do only have to destroy half the number of aerial vehicles than you do with the Sigma 2, but you can't lock on with the RPG, and the most common aerial vehicle is the UAV, which is literally hundreds of meters away, so you've pretty much just got to free fire that RPG and hope that you hit it. But there are some lineup tips I can give for shooting UAVs out of the sky with the RPG, and this does depend on the distance, but for the most part it's going to be more or less the same. And what you want to do is basically you aim down sights of the RPG, you look at the UAV, and then you go about 2 to 3 UAV lengths in front of where the UAV currently is, and then you fire, and that's about as consistent as you can get with destroying UAVs. They are super difficult to destroy, but they are the most common aerial score streak, so it's what you're going to be spending most of your time trying to shoot at with the RPG. Another aerial score streak you can shoot down are counter spy planes. Honestly, I wouldn't bother with these unless you've got no other options up at the time, but if you are going to try and destroy a counter UAV with your RPG, make sure you shoot it a couple of times with your primary with that increased vehicle damage. Bring it down to anything below about 80% health, and then have a go with your RPG. If you don't weaken it beforehand, you're going to have to hit it twice with your RPG, and doing that is practically impossible. It's not all doom and gloom though, because care packages and attack helicopters are the ones that you want to be destroying as often as possible. The RPG one-shots care packages. They fly in pretty low to the ground. They're nice and big and easy to hit. So if there's ever any enemy care packages, drop whatever you're doing, pull out that RPG and make sure you destroy them. It will help you so much in the long run. The same goes for attack helicopters. They're nice and easy to hit, but they've got a lot of health. That's the only issue. So your options are to either just keep shooting at it with the RPG until it gets destroyed, or weaken it massively with your primary weapon and then finish it off with the RPG. Another tip for destroying aerial vehicles with the RPG can be done in Fireteam Dirty Bomb as well. Now for this one, on a lot of the Fireteam Dirty Bomb maps, but not all of them, when you respawn and you parachute in, you actually spawn above the height of UAVs and counter UAVs. This is important because what you can do is you can pull your parachute, and then if there's any UAVs nearby, you can fly over to them and then destroy them from above from point blank distance. This does count towards the challenge and it is pretty easy to do. However, it's kind of inconsistent because it depends on where the UAVs spawn in the Fireteam Dirty Bomb map. It's a massive map, so you're not always going to get lucky with this one. But if you're in Fireteam Dirty Bomb destroying ground streaks, for example, then if you see any UAVs and you get the opportunity to destroy them in this way, absolutely go for it. Honestly though, doing this challenge with the RPG, I did actually find it quite satisfying whenever you destroyed any aerial vehicles, because it's just so cool seeing that rocket fly through the air and eventually hit it, but it is still pretty frustrating for the most part. So the difficulty rating for this challenge with the RPG is no thanks. And with the Sigma 2, it's easy mode. The next challenge, unlocked at level 25, are the science skins. For this, you must destroy 3 score streaks or enemy vehicles in a single game 10 times. In multiplayer. With the Sigma 2, this challenge is going to happen so easy because you can destroy UAVs and just loads of the aerial vehicles without any sort of difficulty. So this challenge absolutely will not be a problem with the Sigma 2. However, again, our good old friend the RPG, this one can be quite annoying. Because it's so difficult to destroy vehicles in the first place with the RPG, destroying 3 in a single game doesn't always happen. So if you find yourself struggling with this challenge, particularly with the RPG, What you can do, and now this is a great tip, but you can actually destroy two vehicles, let's just say UAVs, with the Sigma 2, swap to a class with the RPG on it, and then destroy one more vehicle, whether it's a UAV, care package, or like a sentry turret, and then that will count as one completion towards this challenge for the RPG. As long as the third vehicle is destroyed by the RPG, then that will count towards this challenge. You can progress this challenge multiple times in one match. So for example, if you destroyed 9 UAVs or vehicles with the Sigma 2 in one game, that would count for 3 out of the 10 towards completing this challenge. So for the most part, this challenge is super simple, the Sigma 2, and if you need to use that tip for the RPG, then it becomes pretty easy on that one too. So for that reason, the difficulty rating for this challenge with the Sigma 2 and the RPG is easy mode. And the final skin unlocked at level 30 are the psychedelic skins. In order to unlock this camo, you must get 25 double kills with the Sigma 2 or the RPG. Just thinking about this challenge gives me flashbacks. It is the worst. Honestly, one of the most important pieces of advice I can give for when you're doing this challenge is just be patient with it and try and stay in a good mindset. It's going to be frustrating, and by frustrating I mean infuriating. So try to stay calm, put on some music, just relax, chill out, don't worry too much about it. You'll get there eventually. Keep grinding, I believe in you, and absolutely take a break if you need to. Some people get these things done in one day. I honestly could never do that. It's so annoying. But obviously we'll move on to some more specific tips now. So if this is the final challenge you've got to do and you've destroyed all the vehicles you need to, I would recommend swapping engineer for flak jacket, because you're going to be getting into close quarters with your enemies, and if you shoot a rocket at a nearby enemy, you do not want to be killing yourself as often as possible. So flak jacket is pretty important for getting this challenge done. The absolute best game mode for this challenge is hardcore 12v12 mosh pit or hardcore nuketown 24/7. This is because these playlists have a lot of players on very small maps, so it's very congested, which means that it's not infrequent that you can fire rockets into kind of areas of high traffic, and you're likely to get double kills at least every now and then from doing that. But that method does kind of rely on luck. Obviously there's some skill knowing where the enemies are likely to be, but shooting a rocket at two people who don't have flak jacket is pretty unlikely. So to get around flak jacket, your best bet is to run around trying to melee people with the launchers. Yes, you heard me right, you have to punch people with launchers in order to get this challenge done. It is stupid. I did find that meleeing people is the most consistent way to get this challenge done, but obviously you can mix in shooting rockets, and this works better with the RPG because it's got faster aim down sight time. So what you can do is you can either blow someone up with a rocket and then try and punch someone else, or punch someone and then shoot a rocket at another person, or just punch two people. Any combination, any order, whatever works and gets you that double kill is what you need to be doing. When you're trying to punch people with the Sigma 2 or RPG, use those smokes on the class setup that I explained earlier. They are absolutely invaluable for getting you close to your enemies. They block out those lines of sight. They force enemies to run through the smoke, and you can either wait in the smoke and punch anyone who comes through it, or you can use the smoke to get into a better position to either flank enemies or just get up in their face and be able to hit them. And because you're doing this challenge in hardcore, whether it's nuketown or 12v12, your punches do one-shot enemies, and that's absolutely crucial. I have seen some advice out there saying do this in core and hardcore isn't that great. And yes, in core you do have more life, and that means you can stay alive for longer and it's easier to maneuver around the map. But your enemies also have more life, which means it's even harder to kill them with your rockets, and you have to punch them twice if you want to kill them. So quite frankly, when I tried doing this in core, it's absolute garbage. Please do not do this in core. Hardcore is frustrating. It's so frustrating, I do admit that, but it's infinitely better than core. So just stick it out and you'll get there eventually. Also, when you're going for melee double kills, if you do get behind enemies, make sure you tap your melee button. Do not hold it, because if you hold it, you will assassinate your enemies, and that'll either leave you vulnerable to another enemy shooting you, a teammate stealing your kill, or if it's the second kill, by the time the animation is finished, you won't get the double kill. So make sure you're tapping that melee button if you're behind an enemy. By far, this is the best way you can be getting double kills, but don't take that as me saying this is going to be easy, because it is not. These tips will significantly help you, but it's still going to be a hell of a slog for you. If you hadn't guessed already, the difficulty rating for this challenge with the RPG and the Sigma 2 is f***ing criminal. So this brings us towards the end of the video now. If you've made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I really hope these tips that I've given help you get those diamond launchers nice and quick. Hopefully you don't get too frustrated along the way. I know I certainly did. Before you go though, if this video has helped you, please do leave a like. And if you want to go check out some of the other content on my channel, and maybe even hit that subscribe button if you like what you see, there's plenty of guides on there. There's the unique RNG Camo Mastery series as well. So yeah, thanks for watching. Welcome to my channel. I hope to see you around. And let me know in the comments how you found this grind or how you're getting on with it. I think the diamond launchers are by far one of the hardest camos to unlock in pretty much any COD ever. So best of luck. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.